For those of you who are just joining us, you are live on Urban Today, and thank you very much for tuning in with Didan and, of course, Derek. We're in the segment that we have some, you know, crazy facts here and there. Of course, some history and some jobs and some weather focus. But let's start with the crazy facts that we have for you with is that. So, and this time around, we're going to the artist Bob Marley, the legendary. Mm-hmm. Yeah. May he rest in peace, by the way.
Moment of silence.
No, yes. As you can see on your screens, Bob Marley's last words to his son before he died were, "Money can't buy life." Well, many Slay Queens will choose to disagree with that statement, but it's true.
I can only imagine what Bob Marley was thinking by the time he told those words to his son.
Well, I think he was thinking, I'm not going to be here to guide you guys in life. So the only thing I can tell you is money, because we all love money. I'm not gonna lie, I love
like
money.
He, at this point, he felt like he had made enough money, but he couldn't even save his own life.
No, he couldn't save. Did you see that story about somebody who claimed he was the one who actually killed Bob Marley?
Bob Marley, yes, I did.
There was a story that came out very recently. I didn't get to read
people
much about
the
it.
People have guts, though.
Because I was like, wait, I thought he died of cancer. So I'll read that story and give you more. Now, we're moving on to another is that. So, and this time it's for you, especially when you're in the kitchen. You know, when you're cutting up those onions? Mm-hmm. Yeah, the tears.
You tend to.
So, we do have a very simple trick for you guys. Chewing gum while you cut an onion will help keep you from crying. I have tried it. I have tested it. And yes, it works. The other option is you put it in the freezer for a few, like a minute or two.
The onion?
The onion.
Before you cut it?
Before you cut it. Like, you know, you remove the skin, and then you put it in the freezer for like a minute. Then you bring it out. But the other moments, I used to hate when my mom was telling me, cut onions. I'm
those
like,
tears
can't I
are
do
serious.
Tomatoes?
Those tears are serious.
But you see the work. Like, if you have a broken heart for chicks, since you don't want to be seen crying, you go to the kitchen and you cut the onions. Like, why are you crying? The onions. Kumbe deep down. That stupid boy.
Right. Yeah, it had to be a boy. But with that said, let's go back into history. Back in time, there is 2007, and we're talking about Her Majesty Queen. And it is Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II becomes the oldest ever monarch of the United Kingdom, surpassing Queen Victoria, who lived for 81 years, 7 months, and 29 days. Okay, but people are old.
People are very old.
Kudos to Queen Victoria.
People are very old.
I feel like Mugabe used to use her a lot, and by the time they used
he
to
learned
tell
from
Mugabe,
the best.
Why don't you leave power? It's like, why haven't you told Queen Victoria to leave power?
Yeah, he learned from the best. Let's be serious about it.
I wonder what that guy is up to now.
We shall ask Conan.
Fishing, maybe.
Skinny Mugabe. Talking about jobs now, we do have a job for you coming in from BRAC. Now, BRAC is the world's largest leading development organization dedicated to poverty alleviation and, of course, empowerment of the poor. Now, the vacancy is for farm manager. So send your applications and CVs to recruitment.liberia@brac.net. That is recruitment.liberia@brac.net. The deadline is the 28th of December this year, which is a Thursday. So make sure you grab yourself a copy of the, rather grab yourself, take a screenshot of that email address. And if you're good at farming and you can be a farm manager, well, hello, you have a job waiting on you.
Yes.
Very, very simple like that. Now, weather, I won't lie. When I was coming to work, it was cold. It was really cold.
But in Gulu, the sun came out at 4.
I think Gulu even 3 a.m.
You guy.
The sun
in Gulu is just very serious. So I think we should do a ban today from Gulu one of these days.
No, thanks. No, thank you. I think I'm all right here. We do have the weather forecast for you, so check this out. right, we're back on Urban Today, and I hope you guys are prepared for the weather, all right? With that said, we're getting into our spoken word, and this time it is about a light. A light has come, and this one is by John. Check this.
Starlight, star bright, first star I see tonight. Deep in the dark, creation is humming. A light has come, a light is coming. A light has come, a light is coming. At 299,792,458 meters per second, a light has come, and a light is coming. Light is energy. Its rays and waves greeting us with a bright, sunny face. Light speeds and it spreads, covering everything it touches. It breaks, it illuminates, and it captivates. It stimulates the senses and eliminates the dark. It fascinates the children and generates a spark. It shines, and without it, we're blind, literally. It is only when light enters our eye that we're finally able to see. You see, we as a people living in darkness need a great, great light. So it's no wonder then that out of all the things he could have chosen to create first, God said, "Let there be light," right? So in the middle of the night, when the angel appears to the shepherds' fright, "Do not be afraid," they say, "just follow the light." Starlight, star bright, first son is born tonight to the Virgin Mother, the brother of James, who uttered wonder and suffered under others' blunders to uncover a love for each other and a father and a son shining so brightly. It's only right we called him the light of the world. This light was broken and spread, covering every sin that he touched, illuminating the truth, captivating our attention, and generating our tomorrow. So let this be a sign that the blind can see, that the water is wine, that the broken are free, and his light will shine into every crack of brokenness, over every horizon of hope. Through the prism of his promise, behold, a drummer boy drumming for glory's homecoming and evil succumbing to the light that has come and the light that is coming.
Right, welcome back from the preacher right there. The guy's really preached. He looks like one of those guys who are such good kids.
In chapel boys. We used to call them chapel boys, right?
These are the future pastors.
I feel like he had cock off, he had just
the light is coming.
Yeah, the light said what?
Amen.
Yeah, that's our other profession. But that said, how about we motivate someone for this morning? And it is, do not let people decide your life's fate. Do not think about making art, just get it done. Let everyone else decide if it's good or bad, whether they love it or hate it. While they are deciding, make even more art. Just that simple and precise.
So have you explained it to them?
For you,
it's easier.
It's easier. Now, this is exactly how I managed to sum it up. Live your life. Don't live life to please people. By the time people get to understand the kind of life you're living, for you achieving your goals, don't just sit down and live life because Billy has to be happy also.
There's a light.
Happy. There's a light. Just follow the light. And like they said. Yeah. See you at Fanero.
Okay.
Yeah.
You've given them a Kalango on our show. They need to pay for that. Yeah. It's not free airtime.
They are lucky they do business with us. Or else.
No free airtime on Urban Today. But, guys, we also do have the quote of the day, like you can see on your screens right there. Today's quote of the day: nothing can have value without being an object of utility. And this is coming in from Karl Marx. Nothing can have value without being an object of utility. Utility is usable. Mm-hmm. So there's no value. Even in you, a human, there's no value in you if there's no usable something. Can you sing? Can you dance? Can you write? Can you draw? Can you talk? Mm. Can you think outside the box?
I like the fact that everyone is gifted differently.
Everybody is gifted differently.
People have different talents.
Some people just take longer to find out what their gift is. Mm. Don't worry.
But don't worry. You will get there.
Everybody has. Mm. I mean, some other guys found out they could sing when they were 30.
Mm. Even a Mercedes-Benz boy at 8 is still a Mercedes-Benz. So,
Come on.
Hey! Fire!
I hope you guys are feeling motivated with all of that, from our spoken word to mm-hmm. quotations and, of course, motivation. We're going in for another break. We're going to check out on Nicholas, by the way. We need to find out if he's okay. Those are the ends. But before we get into sports, we still do have the pick of the day. So keep it right here.